Hey everyone, in this video, I'm going to walk you through DaVinci Resolve from start to finish. So this is a complete beginner's guide. There will be timestamps down below for you to go back to sections that you need to cover again. So whether you're editing your first YouTube video, making a short film, or just curious about editing, this beginner tutorial is all you're going to need to get started. And the best part, DaVinci Resolve is completely free. If you go to their website, I will link it in the description of this video right here, blackmagicdesign.com/DaVinci Resolve. You'll be able to download the most recent version, which as recording of this video is DaVinci Resolve 19. It may be 20 or 21 when you're watching this. Just click the free download now button. And there is a paid version, which is the DaVinci Resolve Studio. I'm not going to go over that, but if you're looking for a video editor that is free, where you can do not just personal, but commercial editing as well, DaVinci Resolve is my go-to. And I use the free version. So we'll go ahead and minimize that now. Once it's installed, go ahead and launch the program. It'll look like this when you open it. So this section is going to be the interface overview. When you first open DaVinci Resolve, it's going to feel a bit overwhelming. So let me break it all down for you. You're going to see a couple of tabs down here at the bottom, 7 in total. The first one is media. This is where you import your clips. Next is the cut tab, which is a simplified timeline for faster editing. Next is the Edit tab. This is the main timeline, perfect for detailed edits. Next is the Fusion tab for visual effects and motion graphics. We're not going to cover too much of this today, but I will do an in-depth video on this later. Think of Adobe After Effects or Motion or whatever graphics to, you know, software that you might have used in the past. Next is Color tab. DaVinci Resolve is known for its color grading, so if you're looking to get better at color grading, this is the tool for you. Next is Far Light, which is audio. It's got a built-in audio editor where you can go in here and edit your audio tracks, sound effects, everything within the audio section of your video can be done here in Far Light or in just the edit or cut options as well. And then last will be Deliver. This is where we go and export all of our footage and every sequence, all the projects will be rendered here and exported in the file formats of our choice. You don't need to use every tab. Most beginners will stick with media, cut, edit, and deliver, and that's totally fine. All right, let's go ahead and get started. Section 3, importing media. To get started, go to the media tab, like I've done here, and locate your video files. Now, there's a number of ways that we can do this. I love the way DaVinci Resolve handles media. So let's just say right here, up here in our media storage, if I wanted to, I could just right-click anywhere here, right-click and go to import media. That'll bring up our option here. And then I can select on a couple of video clips or just one and go to open or double-click, and it will bring that media right here into our media tab. Now, if you wanted to, you could just go to the cut option here and you could right-click here, import media directly from this here. And you can go to, say, a video here, hit open, and bring in media that way. Or if you wanted to, you could open up your File Explorer, whether you're using Finder on a Mac or File Explorer on a PC, and you can just click and hold and drag that media directly into the master media bin here. Now, it's going to look different depending on which tab you're in. If you're in the cut option here, which is kind of the more simplistic timeline editor, it'll be up here in the upper left-hand corner. If you are in edit, it may show over here on the left-hand side. So it really just depends on what you want to do. Now, within the media tab here, we can actually create bins. So if you right-click here, go to new bin, you can say audio. So you can say you can have an, you know, bin for audio, and basically that gives you a folder. And then you can say, well, this here is audio. I want to drag that into the audio bin. And now when I select on audio, that way it kind of differentiates the media for you as opposed to you kind of sifting through hundreds of files. And then lastly, you can see that you have all of your drives up here in the upper left-hand corner under the media bin. So as you can see, I have my Macintosh drive here. I can go and find the folder in which I want to upload. And then this is my external hard drive, and I can also choose and work off of it. That's the beauty, is you can have an external hard drive and you can work off of that. When you are ready to create a new project, the first thing that you want to do is you want to go up to File, New Project. Now, give your project a name. So go ahead and give your project a name and click on Create. Once you've done that, you're going to see that there's no media here. So we need to go and import the media like I just showed you how to do. So right click, go to Import Media or drag it, you know, however you want to do it. And then go ahead and click Open or double click. You may see this. It says Change Project Frame Rate. You can change it to be whatever the imported media is or what the project settings is. So go ahead and go to Don't Change here, and I'll show you a little bit about that. If we go up to File and then go to Project Settings, under Project Settings, this lets us know the resolution in which we're editing in, which is the timeline resolution. You can change this to be 4K if you want, but the beauty of DaVinci Resolve is you can edit in 1080p HD format, and then when you export, you can export in 4K, and it'll upscale everything perfectly. But again, depending on the power of your Mac or PC that you're using, you may want to edit in 4K, and that's completely fine. And the only other thing I would look at here would be right here where it says timeline frame rate. I normally do 24 for my wedding films, and then I also do around 50 for my YouTube videos. So choose the frame rate that you want. You may want to do a little research in that. Don't worry about any of this down here. Leave all of that alone, and then go ahead and click Save. All right, now that our project is created, we're going to the Edit tab, and we're going to start with basic editing. So what do you do? So we have our media over here on the left-hand side. We have a video here. I'm going to go ahead and click and hold to drag that. Now, if the video has audio, you're going to see that it is linked together. So if we drag that video that has audio, your audio will be here, which is the green track, and your video will be here on video one. And we'll talk about other tracks as we go. So as you can see, if I click and hold and move that on my timeline, it's going to stay together. If I wanted to, I could just right-click this here, and right here where it says Link Clips, I can click that, and it will allow me to individually move the audio and the video. Now, there's something else that I want to show you. Up in the upper right-hand corner of your interface, you're going to see this option here. This allows you to see your selected media over here, and then your final timeline video over to the right. Now, if this bothers you or confuses you, just click on the single option here to change this back to single viewer mode and get out of the double viewer mode. So that might be something that's bothering you. And if it is, you can just go to single viewer mode and see only what's in the timeline. And I will show you a little bit of advanced editing here in a second. Now, how do we basically shorten or trim clips? Well, you can select a clip here. You can see if we highlight over to the left-hand side there, it's going to bring up the little slider where we can click and hold and drag the video. So we can decrease and increase the duration of the video and make simple cuts from the ends of the video. If we want to make a cut, say right here where our playhead is, I'm going to mute our audio here, we will go ahead and use our blade tool. So if we go here and go to blade edit mode or B on your keyboard, you can see when we hover over a track, the razor blade comes up and I can click right there and it makes a cut. Now, if you unlink the video and audio, you can see I actually have to cut the audio and video separately. So as you can see now under the audio track here, I'll have to make the cut here for the audio. And then we just go and use our selection tool, which is just the selection mode or P on your keyboard, select both those tracks. And now right there where I made the cut, I can individually go and I can drag those different tracks. Now, with anything, you can go to Command or Control Z to undo if that's what you want to do. The next thing I'm going to talk about is adding simple transitions by dragging them from the effects library. Before we work with any of the transitions, I want to show you within your timeline, you can use this plus and minus symbol to zoom in. So if I click and hold this and drag this, you can see it's actually going to allow me to zoom in and zoom out. You know, once you have it zoomed in to where you want, let's go ahead and go back over to our transitions. So what we want to do to add a transition is to go over and find the transition that we want to use, and we can hover over it and highlight it and show what it looks like if we basically just go left to right with our mouse. So we'll click and hold and drag that to where we want it on our timeline. And as you can see, this little white thing comes available at the end here. This is showing you where that transition is. It's a cross dissolve. So if we move our playhead, we can see the transition was indeed added. Now, with anything, we can click and highlight that transition. You can see it's highlighted with red there. And we can increase or decrease by dragging the time or transition itself. And now when we play it back, the transition will last a bit longer. And now we can click and hold and we can drag our other media back. So when the transition plays here, it'll go right back to this video here. So if you want to add transitions and not just do hard cuts, you can do so by going to the effects tab, finding the transition of your choice, and then dragging that into or onto the video. Now, if it's an audio transition, it's a little different. Let's say we want to add a crossfade here. We can click and hold that crossfade and we can add that to our audio, and this will crossfade from this audio track to the next. Next thing I want to talk about is scaling or resizing your video, zooming in and changing the position. So in order to do that, you would select your video track here on your timeline, and then you'd go up here to the upper right-hand side of your interface and go to Inspector. Under Inspector, you make sure Video is selected, if that's indeed what you're trying to change, and then you can see here we have the Zoom option where we can click and hold and zoom in by dragging to the right. We can click and hold and zoom out by dragging to the left. Very simple and very easy. So if you wanted to here, just like so, you could drag that, zoom it into that area there. And then what you could do is with positioning, you could go here and you could select by clicking and holding, and this changes the X axis. And then if you go here, this changes the up and down or Y axis. Now, we can add animations by adding keyframes and all of that, but just for today, we are going to show you how to zoom in and out and how to move the positioning with the Inspector tab on the right-hand side. Next is going to be adding titles and effects. So, want to add text? All you have to do is go here to our Effects tab, which we click right here to make sure it's available to us. And then under the toolbox, make sure it is expanded. We want to go to titles. Now, with titles, you can add lower thirds. All the different fusion titles here are actually titles that are going to move. So if you want one to basically background reveal from the black border, or you want something to kind of show up, what you would do is you would select the title that you want to use, click and hold it, and drag it somewhere on your timeline. Now when we play the video back, you can see here's our title here, and you can see what it looks like here on your timeline. And then if we did want to change kind of where it is and the size, we can make sure our Inspector tab is open again, and we can click the size option here, and we can change the size of the text here. We can change the tracking, which basically changes the, you can play around with all of these settings to make it look how you want. Now, the V anchor with this specific title is going to be kind of where the text is, and the H anchor is kind of this one here as far as the X or Y axes and where it shows up. Now, text position, you got your color of the text, you can change all of this. And then right here where it says sample, we can obviously just type in text or a title or whatever you want it to show, and then basically that's how you play around with it. I'd play around with all of these settings. You can change the font, the color, everything will be directly here within the Inspector panel to the right. As with anything on your timeline, you can click and hold the ends of it and drag left or right to increase or decrease the duration in which you see the text showing up on your screen. So this is kind of what the text and everything looks like all together within your timeline. If you wanted to, you could even double click onto your timeline to bring up the Inspector if the Inspector tab is not open. All right, now let's move into color correction. So if we go here to our color tab, right here is our color tab, and you can see that I have different kind of selections here. This is my timeline and different clips. So each clip that is cut, so let's say you have four different clips in a timeline, you will be editing them individually unless you select them all and apply what they call a LUT or a color grade that applies to everything. We're just going to be talking about basics today. The easiest way to get started with color grading in DaVinci Resolve is to open up the color tab here and then open up the color wheel. So you'll have your different options. You'll have this option here. You'll have a couple of color slices. You'll have the curves. I like the color wheels, which is my primary one that I work with, at least where I start. And then what you'll do is you have your shadows here and your highlights. So if something is too bright or something is too dark, you may need to decrease or increase shadows and highlights. So let's just bring our shadows up a little bit. It'll make it the darks a little brighter. And if we bring our highlights down, that'll bring our whites and make them a little lower. So depending on what type of video you're working with, you may want to look at what you're seeing first, kind of get a base of what you're working with, and then go down here and adjust your shadows and highlights first, then maybe play around with the contrast before you get into working with specific colors and tints and things like that. I would watch a dedicated video on color grading, and it may be something I do a deeper dive on into the future. And then lastly, I want to mention that they do have an auto color option, which basically does it for you. It's an auto balance. If you click that button there, it's the A with a circle around it. It does a fairly good job. So you might want to start there, see kind of what it does to your footage. And if you like the results, you don't have to do anything yourself. So if you are worried or scared about color grading, again, just know you can use that auto balance feature here. It's the A with a circle around it. Next, let's go into audio editing, and audio is crucial. So if we go to Fairlight, which is the option with this button here, you're going to see that all of our audio here is in the track. So we see all of our audio. We don't see our video here. This is just for audio mixing. So if you have a number of tracks or sound effects, you can go into this area here and you can work with audio. But I'm going to show you in the Edit tab, as a beginner, where I would start with audio. So if we zoom in here to our timeline and I hover over this little line with my audio track here, you're going to see up and down arrows. They're going to be white. And if we click and hold here, you can see I will change the decibel or the volume of said track. So if I click and hold, I drag that down, it's going to decrease the volume. If I drag this up, it's going to increase the volume. Now, what I always tell people is if we go over here and bring up our mixer. So right here where you see the inspector, if we click on mixer, it'll bring up the mixer here that you see in the right-hand corner here. This is our audio one. This is our different track here. And now if we press play, you can see over here on our mixer that we're getting in the red a little bit on that track. So what I like to do is I always tell people you want to tickle the red, which means that you want it to just go up to where the yellow meets the red, but you don't want it to get in the red very much. So I would decrease that track like so. I would put my playhead back here. And now when I play it, you can see it's still hitting the red just a bit. So I may decrease that even more. If you wanted to, if you clicked on the audio track here, go up to our inspector tab, select the audio tab, you can even do your detailed audio mixing here. Now, what if we wanted to do a fade out or fade in? We would need to add keyframes to our audio track. So we're going to go ahead and zoom in really far here. And if I go and hover right here and I see the white arrows here, if you hit Alt on the PC or you hit Option on a Mac, you can see I can Option click or Alt click and add a keyframe. And then I can do it again by Alt or Option clicking again. And that brings up another keyframe. So I would do that at the beginning of where I want the fade to start going down. And then I would go over here and I would do two more to where I wanted it to come back up. But for the case of this audio track, I'm going to have it fade out. So what I'd do is I'd click and hold that audio keyframe here and I would drag it to the end here and I'd put it at the very bottom to have that audio fade out. So now when I play it back, it'll kind of fade the audio out. That's how you add and kind of change the audio keyframes. And then now, lastly, we're going to cover the deliver tab or exporting your video. So click on the rocket ship that says deliver here, and we'll see our timeline at the bottom. And now on the left-hand side, we are going to see all of our export options. So you want to choose the preset that you like. So make sure your file name is what you want it to be. And the location, if we click on browse, this is where you choose on your PC or Mac where you want the video to go. So I want it to go here, and I want the name to be timeline one. And then we want to render as single clip, not as individual clips. If you render them individually, it will export as individual or multiple clips. So do single clip here. Make sure you have video selected. Now, all of this is really dependent on what you need. I choose MP4 or QuickTime, depending on kind of what project I'm working on. And then for the codec, I choose H.264 because the other one tends to not play well with certain people's systems and things like that. And then as far as resolution, timeline resolution is going to be the timeline edit. So if you are editing in HD, it's going to export in HD, 1080p. If you are editing in, say, 4K, then it's going to export in 4K. But if you want it to do a different format from what you were editing in, then what you would do is you would select the drop-down menu here, and then you would go and slide down and say, hey, I want this to be, say, 4K, 6K, whatever footage that you're working with. But for me, I'm going to go timeline resolution because I was already editing in 4K. Frame rate is going to be right here. You select this, and the drop-down options of what you can choose for frame rate for this project will be here. So for the timeline, for me, I believe I did this one in 24, but I could change it to 50 if I wanted to. I normally leave that to timeline frame rate because I'm normally editing in what frame rate I want to export into. Everything else I'd leave alone. I would not mess with it. When you're ready to go, what you'll do is you will add this to the render queue. Now, this is not exporting. If we add this to the render queue, it'll go up here into the render queue in the upper right-hand corner. Now, in order to export, you would go to render all. Now, when you go to render all, you can see it's progressing up here in the right-hand corner. It is actually exporting your video as we speak, and you should see the duration and how long it's going to take up here in the upper right-hand corner. When it's done, you should see up here where it says job one completed and how long it took to complete. Now, if we open up our File Explorer or Finder for Mac, you can see here is the video, timeline one, that I just exported, and I can play it back. That's it. You just edited your first video in DaVinci Resolve. Hopefully this tutorial helped you out. Please like and subscribe if it did for more easy-to-follow tech tutorials like this. And if you have any questions about DaVinci Resolve, drop them in the comments below. Myself and the community are happy to help. See you in the next video.